So we have a question over here. Time constant of an inductive coil is 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 second. When 60 ohm resistance is added in series, the time constant reduces to 9.5 10 raised to the power minus 3 second. The inductance of the coil is, okay. So initial the case is tau is L by R, and this is given as 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3. When a resistance of 60 ohm is added in series, the time constant becomes what? Reduces to 9.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 second. Okay, from 2 to 9.5 10 raised to the power minus 3 second. That's what it is given in the question itself. Okay, let me check the powers. This is okay. Time constant reduces to 9.5 10 raised to the power minus 3 second. There can be the error in the values because the time constant is actually increasing in this case. Either the above time constant should be 10 raised to the power minus 5 or the below constant will be 10 raised to the power minus 5. So I'm considering according to the option we have to adjust the data. So let's divide them. So L by R into L by R plus 60. Okay. So 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 divided by 9.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 5. So this should be minus 5 actually. Let's please correct this. Okay, this should be plus minus 5. So LL cancel out. So R plus 60 upon R is equal to. So this is coming out to be 20 by 95. And into 10 raised to the power 2 means 2000 by 95. 5 4s are 20. 5 1s are 5, 4 9, 5 9s are 45. This is 19R plus 19 into 60. That's what we need to multiply. So 19 multiplied by 60 is equal to 1140. 1140 is equal to 400R. Okay. So let's solve for the next step. So 400. Okay. 400 minus 19. Is equal to 381. Okay, so we can write 381R is equal to 1140. 1140. So R will be 1140 by 381. Okay, so let's divide this. Now we need to divide 1140 divided by 381. That is equal to approximately 3. That's what it is coming. 3 ohm. Okay, but that is the value of R. We need to calculate L, self inductance. So L will be, we are using the equation number 1, R multiplied by, so 2R multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 3. So 6 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 3. Okay, 3 to the 6. Okay, so this will be 6 into 10 raised to the power minus 3, or to be precise, this is actually 2.99. Okay, so let's multiply this by 2. We are getting 5.98. Approximately, we can say it is like this. So I have a little doubt about this power. So let's take 10 raised to the power minus 3 into consideration and let's try to solve this. I'm taking 10 raised to the power minus 3 only here as well. If let's stick to the data. So we are getting with 20 divided by 9.5. So as per the question, this is the way to solve such a problem. Okay. So yeah. So we are getting 5 4s are 20, 5 1s are 5, 4 9, 5 9s are 45. 4 by 19 is what we are getting. So 90R plus this is equal to 40R. So 40 minus 19, that's what we need to do. Okay. So 40 minus 19 is equal to 21. So 21R is equal to, instead of this, we should write 21R. Okay. So 21R is equal to 1140. So let's divide 1140 by 21. So we are getting 54. Yeah, we are getting the exact answer. So the data is correct. But R is what R is not asking to us. They are asking the value of it is asking 54.28. the value is coming 54.28. okay, so let's place it 54.28 ohm, but they are asking the value of this. So after placing 54.28 multiplication with this, okay, so let's multiply this 54.28 multiplied by 2, we are getting 108.5 millihenry. That's what I am saying. Please check the question. There should be error in these powers, or the values can be anything. But otherwise, this is the procedure to solve such a question. Hope this answered your question. Thank you very much.